My name is Claire, and this is my best friend, Justin. So far this trip, we've hiked, fished, experienced unforgettable flights, and soaked in hot springs, all while living in a camper van. We're in desperate need of a shower, but that's not going to stop us from stuffing as much action as possible into our last full day together in Alaska.
I got up at midnight looking for northern lights because last night we missed them. The night before last is when we missed them. We're starting to get tired. We're having to force ourselves up earlier than we want to today because we have to drive to Seward, which is an hour away, and we have a boat ride to catch at 8:30 a.m. I have Dramamine. I'm prepared.
The sun's coming up. Should be a really, really beautiful morning. I'm not a morning person, so waking up early enough to greet the sun is typically something I reserve for special occasions like this. As our boat pulled out of the harbor into Resurrection Bay, it almost felt like we were tiptoeing into the sunrise, taking special care not to disrupt the perfect, peaceful morning. I scanned the shorelines and mountainsides, hoping to finally see some wildlife. Thankfully, our guide had a much better eye than we did, and she easily spotted eagles, mountain goats, sea lions, and even jellyfish. Once the sun was up, we picked up the pace and put our rain jackets to good use.
It's like a roller coaster ride, I love it!
This little excursion toured the Kenai Fjords for 3.5 hours while our guide pointed out key features of the landscape and told countless stories about the area's history.
In Khaosan, we stayed on the water and they had to bring us to the little glamping spot on the water.
Yes.
So you can do that here. How much do you think it costs per night?
$700.
It's $700 a night and does not include food. You have to bring your own food.
A night?
Yes, it's a lot.
Unfortunately, the fun didn't last because I got seasick. The off-brand Dramamine I took failed and forced me to retreat to the cabin for most of the ride home.
All right, Justin, what'd you think?
I had so much fun.
Yeah,
that was outside the entire time.
Yeah, Justin did not go inside the cabin the entire trip. I was not feeling great during the second half of that, but it was so worth it. It was really fun. We're really lucky she pointed out so many animals to us, because I wouldn't have seen a single one of those animals if she hadn't actually pointed them out, because they were very difficult to see within the landscape. So I bet we've missed a bunch of animals this trip based on the fact that we're just not very good at spotting them.
I think in general, the fatigue is really starting to set in for me. I'm tired.
I'm not tired at all.
What? You're not tired? Oh boy, okay.
This might be a good time for me to have that chocolate energy boost thing.
Yeah.
The other one was kind of fruity. It tasted like cough syrup almost. This one's just chocolate, and I like this one.
That one's good?
This one's good. The light of day shows how badly my car wash actually went.
One of the sweet little things that we've seen in the cities here are tiny little huts where you drive up and get espresso. There's a really cute espresso hut here. It's actually in the shape of a coffee mug, and it's adorable. So we're gonna stop by there, then we're gonna get lunch, and then we're gonna hike the exit glacier, and then that's basically the whole trip.
We went from fall to winter, to fall to winter, to summer! It's summer now!
Our last hike of the trip is a sweet little hike up to Exit Glacier. Justin's knee is hurting, my knee is hurting, so we're taking it easy today. That trail was too easy. We want more! It's cool though, look, a glacier. That wasn't a hike, that was a leisurely stroll. So we're attempting to do the 8 mile hike we were avoiding because we're both in pain. And we have a fairly limited amount of time to do it. We may not finish, but we want to give it a try because it's our last day. There's 3 overlooks. So we only really have to get part of the way up to get a really good view of the glacier from above. Since it's our last nice full day in Alaska, I figured I'd do a Q&A with you guys. So I put out a call for questions on Instagram, on YouTube, and my Discord for my Twitch community. We're gonna try and answer some questions for you. We'll be doing this throughout the rest of the trip, just to sort of give y'all some more information that y'all seem to be curious about. We've been trying to figure out what went wrong with me today, because this shouldn't have been this hard. And we think that it's a combination of taking Dramamine for the boat ride and then getting seasick on the boat ride and then hiking 4 miles and then starting this hike right after. And I didn't get a good night's sleep last night, and so all those things just sort of came together to make it a perfect storm of me being pathetic. I feel better now. I'm still really tired, but I'm really, really happy that we did this, because this is our last nice weather day of the trip, and it would have been a shame to spend most of it in a car. So I'm really glad that we got that extra view, because it was way better than the view from the other trail.
The other one's not even worth it.
Yeah, I wouldn't even bother with that other trail. Just do this one, because it's a way better view. Ugh. We were on our way to a free spot, but then stumbled across Quartz Creek Campground. It's free in the winter, and we have a fire pit and a picnic table and access to the water, and we're sold. Oh, you put onions in it?
Yeah.
Yummy. Is that okay? Yeah.
After this, I'm making those apples, so.
Oh.
I think it's a good night for it, right?
Yeah, yummy. This is great, Justin. Thank you. Baked apples topped with walnuts and raisins and cinnamon.
I don't understand how you do this. So good.
We're doing a little Q&A, and you guys had a lot of questions. First one is, how did you and Justin come up with Alaska as a destination?
So we was between Hawaii and Alaska because we wanted to keep in the United States.
Just to sort of avoid any additional travel hiccups that come from COVID. So everything's cheaper this time of year in Alaska, and yeah. So we figured we'd go ahead and come here and save money.
Were there any points you and Justin looked at each other and said, should have done Hawaii?
I thought that was a funny question, because we didn't actually publicize that Hawaii and Alaska were our choices. I don't think I ever had a moment like that. Did you?
While we were planning, I was reading a lot of blogs that basically said, don't come to Alaska this time of year. All the blogs said it was supposed to be raining the entire time. So maybe we just got really lucky with weather because we haven't had any rain. Is it difficult to get in and out of bed?
Stop. Yes. Well, it's because it's so freaking cold that when you're in your sleeping bag, you feel very warm and comfortable. I was so comfortable at night for the most part. I had maybe one or two rough nights. How were your nights?
I mean, waking up every now and then, but nothing bad.
Yeah.
I slept fine. Waking up, though, I don't sleep in all the layers, so you have to get out of bed, and then you're cold because you're out of your sleeping bag, so then you have to try to put layers on.
For me, it's a lot easier for me to get up out of bed than for him, because yeah. When I get up out of bed, he's like, you want some tea? You're always the first person to wake up.
I wake up early.
We're making an impromptu stop at the Alaska Wildlife Conservation Center. They have lots of different animals here, and since we haven't seen as many animals as we wanted to this trip, we thought it would be a cool way to support their cause.
It's not a zoo, it's actually animals have either been injured or rescued.
I appreciate this petting chart. Nope, vacation over if you have insurance. What in the heck are these things? They look like baby bison, maybe? It's so cute!
Definitely like grabs onto it.
Aww. The weather
weather said it was going to rain.
The storm was delayed, and last I checked, it's not going to hit Anchorage.
We're officially tired. We're just tired. We're gonna try and go back to the hotel and check in as soon as check-in starts. But for now, we're gonna make a sandwich because it's a pretty view.
We are finally back at civilization. It's warm. We have hot showers coming. They let us in early. So it's only 2:30 and we already have a hotel room. Thank goodness.
Everything didn't smell that bad when it was in the van, but now that it's inside a clean room, everything smells horrible. We are freshly showered and warm and clean, and we are doing just the teeny tiniest little walk, half a mile to the Glen Alps Overlook. And then we're gonna try and sit and answer some questions for you guys. What's the setup and tear down time for the tent and how spacious is it? And then someone else asked, how cold does the tent get? So basically, explain the tent.
Tent is just super easy, it just pops up.
Mm-hmm. The biggest problem that we had with the tent was condensation. So during the night, water would get all over the inside of the tent.
Yeah.
And then when you close it, some of the water would get on the bedding. And I think that's one of several reasons we ended up sleeping in the car for most of the trip instead of using the tent. It was cool, but we had a sleeping bag and blankets. And so I would put the blanket all the way over my head and then have my body in the sleeping bag so that I could breathe but still have warm air all around me. Has it been hard getting groceries in Alaska and keeping food fresh?
Our fridge is very, very small, so we really didn't have the luxury of having a lot of fresh groceries. We chose some that wouldn't get bad, like tomatoes and onions that we could keep outside of the fridge. I just kind of came up with an easy food menu that would have some veggies, but not a ton of variety, just because it makes it easier. It's Justin doing everything, cooking and driving? No.
Yes, Justin's doing everything.
So I drive because I can't read while in the passenger seat or in the car. So at least when I'm driving, I feel like I'm like contributing. So.
If he's driving, then I'm filming and I'm looking up campgrounds and posting on social media, but we didn't have a lot of signal this trip. So I'm able to accomplish a lot in the passenger seat that Justin can't.
And then with the cooking, it's because I like to cook. I like the different flavors and I brought all the spices that I needed and everything. Well, Claire would be happy with peanut butter and jelly sandwiches for the whole trip. I'm doing it more for me.
I do all the cleaning, basically.
And she does do all the cleaning.
I clean up after the meals, and I clean up the car, and I set up the bed, and
we find ways to like split some of the work up.
I feel like you take on more than I do.
It doesn't feel like it, though, so I'm not like, oh, I have to cook again.
We had a lot of questions about bathrooms. There's no bathroom in the van and there's no shower in the van. I was surprised by the number of campgrounds that had some sort of outhouse.
There's also a ton of rest stops.
I peed in the woods a lot. I bought one of those stand-up lady peer things.
Do you know a piece of plastic to pee in costs $20?
I didn't use it a single time.
And we also bought a trowel so we could properly dig holes.
You have to dig a hole.
Away from water sources and trails. Mm-hmm. And
I didn't have to do that this trip.
I did. Yes. I have a pretty consistent schedule, and sadly it didn't line up with bathrooms.
The thing that was inconvenient was the lack of a shower.
Yeah, I miss the shower, especially because it's cold. So like a nice hot shower after a hike, it always feels amazing. Mm.
What makes for a good travel partner? Patience.
If you have someone who gets easily angry or upset, then that would be really hard.
Yeah, we're both fairly patient. I think I'm quicker to lose my morale or become in a bad mood, but I also do my absolute best to not take that out on you.
Yeah, you never do. It's probably the most challenging trip we've been in.
100%. Yeah. 100%. This is the toughest trip we've ever done.
Have you been worried about snow making the roads impassable? I haven't.
It was fine, but I was nervous. You weren't nervous, but I was.
Alaska, I mean, they're used to it, so the roads were clear.
What do you regret not bringing / buying? The camper van did not have a can opener.
Oh, yeah.
It had everything for the kitchen that you needed, except a can opener.
That was the worst part.
That was the worst part of the van. No can opener. I regret not owning more military-grade long underwear.
I brought 5 pairs of leggings, and these are the only ones I wore outside.
My really good long underwear were so good, I refused to wear anything else, so I just wore the same long underwear every day for 10 days without washing them.
What do you regret not bringing / buying?
No regrets.
No regrets.
Tips for comfort in the van.
Make sure you have the right gear for the temperature that you're in. So if you're going somewhere really cold, get yourselves one of these ridiculously expensive jackets, because let me tell you, they cost a lot of money, but they work. I was jealous of Justin because he had two pairs of shoes. So he'd get one wet, and the next day he'd wear the dry ones. And during that day, the wet ones would dry. You saw me by the fireside holding up my shoes, letting them dry at night.
Nothing dries here.
Yeah, it was tough. I think the final question was cost breakdown and budget.
Biggest expense was the van.
The van cost $2,184.35.
And that includes insurance and roadside service just in case we get flat tires. And that's off-season pricing.
Yeah.
And the cheapest option I've got.
Most hotels here cost a minimum of $100
to $175 easily.
And then if you had to rent a car on top of that, the camper van was really the cheapest option, even though it
did
cost a lot.
And even the Airbnbs were priced same prices as hotels.
This was the trip to Alaska that we wanted.
Yeah.
I don't think I would ever go back and do it a different way, and I'm really happy with how it turned out, and it happened to be the cheapest way. As far as groceries go, if you include us getting coffee and getting a McDonald's one day,
yes.
Then it's up to $300. So $300 for 10 days, three meals a day, that's 30 meals for $300. No, math. 10? Okay. 30 meals each. So it's an average of $5 a meal per person.
Yeah.
Gas, $250 on gas. The other really huge expenses were the private flight over Denali, which cost...
That's a splurge.
$507 per person.
Yeah, worth it.
It cost more than our flight to Alaska. And it was my favorite thing that we did.
My favorite thing too.
Best $500 I've ever spent. The helicopter ride was $390 per person and was not worth it. Our boat ride, $180 per person.
Oh, with taxes, yeah.
One other expense was firewood. We spent $26 on firewood.
Yeah.
It was wonderful. I loved every second of our fire time. It's definitely one of our more expensive trips that we've done.
But I think total is going to be around $3,000 each for this trip. That's what it costs here, though.
Like, yeah. It's expensive.
Like $3,000 in Thailand is going to be
You could spend months in Thailand on $3,000.
Yeah. So.
We have to go now because we are cold. If you have any other questions for us, just throw them in the comment section below and I'll try and answer some. Super thrilled with this trip. It was beautiful. Now, let's make some dinner. Justin left this morning at like 6 a.m. I was barely awake. He had to go catch his plane to California. So I am here on my last day by myself. It feels very weird to be by myself, I'm not gonna lie. But I really didn't want to waste this day because I don't have a flight until later in the evening. And there is this really sweet little park called Kincaid Park that was only 15 minutes from my hotel. And so I'm gonna go on a little walk. The issue with this park is that the trails here are endless. There's so many paths and trails. I'm not entirely sure where I'm gonna walk or for how long. So enjoy a little bit of this wandering through Kincaid Park before I leave for home.
Thanks so much for joining us on this trip to Alaska. If you'd like to follow our upcoming adventures, make sure to subscribe and I'll see you on my next trip.